Hello students, good morning to all. Today we will discuss the topic magnetism. Magnets are used in our day-to-day life for various activities. So first let us know what is magnets. Magnets are the objects of stone, metal or other materials which have the property of attracting metals like iron, cobalt and nickel. So this is called as magnets. The attracting property of a magnet is called as magnetism. And also the branch of physics which deals with the property of magnet is called as magnetism. Now we are going to learn about the discovery of a magnet. A magnet was discovered by a shepherd boy who lived in Asia Minor, name called Magnesia. One day he was looking after his sheep. He was slept near the mountain area. He used to hold the iron stick in his hand. The iron in the stick attracted by the rocks near the mountain area. He was shocked and surprised that it was a god. So by the name of the shepherd boy, the magnetic rock was named as magnetite. So magnet discovered in the place Magnesia by the shepherd boy Magnus. Next, the Chinese are the people who know the property of magnet at earliest. The Chinese known the property of magnet before 200 BC itself. They use the magnetic compass for navigations in the ship in 1200 AD itself. Students, magnets play an important role in our day-to-day life. So now let us learn the uses of magnet. So the magnet used in the refrigerator door, computer parts, car engines and elevator, electromagnet used in the lift and crane, etc. So the magnet are used in the various machines. Now let us learn the classification of magnets. The magnets are classified into two types. They are natural magnets and artificial magnets. Students, now let us learn them one by one. The first one is natural magnets. Magnets found in the nature is called as natural magnet. They are the permanent magnet. They never lose their attractive magnetic power. These natural magnets found in the sandy deposits in various places. Lodestone is called as magnetite. It's a natural magnet. And
puritite, ferrite, columbite also are the examples of natural magnets.
So students, the natural magnet found in nature, they are the permanent magnet. They never lose their property. They have no shape. So these are the properties of natural magnets. Students, next we are going to study about an artificial magnets. Magnets are prepared by man in the laboratory is called as artificial magnet. It is also called as man-made magnet. These artificial magnets are very very strong in nature.
But they lose their power at particular period.
They are available in a different shapes. They are bar, U-shaped, horseshoe, cylindric, disc-shaped magnet and ring magnet, electromagnet are the examples of artificial magnets. So the artificial magnets are available in a different shapes. Iron, nickel, cobalt, steel,
neodymium,
samarium also an example of artificial magnet. So students, the artificial magnet is a man-made magnet. It's very strong. They are available in a different shapes. So these are the properties of artificial magnets. Students, next we are going to study about the differences between natural magnets and artificial magnets. The first one is natural magnet. The natural magnets found in the nature and they are irregular in shape. They don't have any shape. Next, the artificial magnets are made by the man. They made in a different shapes. The strength of the natural magnet is well determined. So they never lost their magnetic power. But the artificial magnets have some particular specific strength. So they lose their property sometimes. The natural magnets are long-lasting magnets. They never lose their property. But artificial magnets are time-bound, means they lose their property sometimes. Natural magnets' usage is very less in our day-to-day life, but artificial magnet used in various ways in our day-to-day life. So they have a vast usage in our day-to-day life. These artificial magnet is used in various machines. Now let us learn about the magnetic properties. The magnets have attractive properties, repulsive property and directive properties. Now let us learn them one by one. The first one is attractive property. The magnet always attract the material such as iron, nickel and cobalt. To understand this concept, let us see the activity. Take some iron fillings and keep the magnets near them. Usually the magnet has two poles. They have north and south poles. The poles of the magnet have more attractive power than the other area. So more iron fillings are attracted near the north and south pole. So this is called as attractive property. So the magnet has north and south poles. Usually the poles of magnet have more attractive power, which attract iron, copper and nickel. Next property is repulsive property. Now take the bar magnet and suspend it from the support. So the bar magnet have two poles, north and south pole. Now bring the south pole of the another magnet close to the south pole of the suspended magnet. Usually the same poles of the magnets repel each other. So the same poles are like poles of magnet repel each other. So the same poles, north-north poles repel and south-south pole repel each other. But north and south poles of two magnets attract each other and south and north poles of two magnets attract each other. So same poles or like poles repel each other. Two different poles, unlike poles, attract each other. So this is called as repulsive property. Students, the last property is called as directive property. Now take the bar magnet and suspend it from the support. So usually the north poles and south poles of the magnets align itself to the geographic north and geographic south. So south poles always points towards the geographical south and north poles always points towards the geographical north. So they align themselves along with the geographic north and geographic south. They show the direction, north and south direction always. So students, the magnet have attractive power, repulsive power and directive power.